Everyone, today in this I'm going to explain how to do this beautiful table mat or table runner. So first I will show you the design of the item, and then I will explain step by step how to go through. So as the beginning, I made 9 chains and then made it as a circle. So first make 9 chains with your yarn. I have taken a single plier yarn, very thin, off white color. And so the first step, make 9 chains and make a circle out of it, then start inserting double crochets. Three chains, I take it as the first double crochet in the circle, then another double crochet, another double crochet. So 3 double crochets together, and then I insert 4 chains and again 3 double crochets. So 3 chains, no 4 chains and 3 double crochets together. So in this circle, the first step, I'm going to make 6 pairs of 3 double crochets, and in between each pair of double crochet I inserted 4 chains. End of the first round. So you can see there are 6 pairs of 3 double crochets and 6 pairs of 3 double crochets and 6 4 chain blanks. Now 3 chains and start from the first double crochet, inserting double crochets again. in the second round. So a double crochet and a double crochet. To the three double crochets we inserted in the previous round, and to the four chains I'm inserting again double crochets, three double crochets and four chains, and again three double crochets into the same four chain space. So in this round that four chain space is filled with three double crochets, middle four chains, again three double crochets, and then these double crochets are filled with double crochets again. In the third round, each double crochet of the previous round will be inserted another double crochet, but to the end double crochet of each pair I inserted three double crochets. So in the previous row I have made three double crochet pairs. At the end of each three double crochet pairs of the first row, now each pair has three double crochets in the middle and both sides three double crochet pairs. All together each pair now has nine double crochets at the end of the second row. So in the third row, to the first double crochet and the ninth double crochet of the pair I inserted three double crochets, and then four chains in the middle, and continue with the same pattern. So three double crochets to the first double crochet, and then we go normally, inserting one double crochet each to each double crochet, and to the end double crochet I inserted three double crochets, and then four chains and go to the next pair.
Thank you.
finished the fourth row as well. In the fourth row, what I did is I added 2 double crochets to the end double crochet of the previous row, that pairs. So now it takes the shape of a triangle. Now the beginning of the in this row again, to that 4 chain space, I inserted 3 double crochets, 4 chains, 3 double crochets, and the previous row double crochet pairs, I inserted 2 double crochets to the last one and then continued with single double crochets to each double crochet of the previous row. So in the 4 chain space, I inserted 3 double crochets, 4 chains and 3 double crochets, and to the end of the pair, that double crochet, I inserted 2 double crochets, and all the other double crochets were done with inserting double crochets. In this round, the beginning of the pineapple motif is going to start. So as the beginning, I inserted 15 double crochets to the 4 chains I left here in the previous row. 15 double crochets to the 4 chains I left in the middle. 15 double crochets And then three chains, 15 double crochets, three chains, and then insert as a double crochet to the middle double crochet of the previous row. There in this pair I had 19 double crochets, so I inserted my double crochet to the 10th double crochet of the previous row. So three double crochets, three chains, and three double crochets to the same hole, or to the 10th double crochet. Here I have inserted three double crochets. Three chains and three double crochets, again three chains, and go to the next four chains we left in the previous row, and there insert 15 double crochets.
Thank you.
row, every double crochet of the previous row will be stitched with the double crochet, but in between there will be a chain. Like to the first double crochet, a double crochet and a chain, and a double crochet to the next one. Again a chain, a double crochet to the next one. So that 15 double crochets will be expanded further, and it will look like a semicircle after this row. End of this row, I'm going to show you how the pineapple is started from the next row. Now we have expanded the 15 double crochets of the previous row, 3 chains, and insert it to the first chain we left after the first double crochet of the previous row. Chain we left, always it is 3 chains, and then insert as a double as a single crochet to the chain we left in the previous row. So that is what we are doing all over this round, 3 chains to this blank, 3 chains to the blank or to the chain we left in between 2 double crochets. So between 2 double crochets we have left a chain, so that after 3 chains insert as a double, as a single crochet to that chain we left in between the 2 double crochets. End of this row, I'm going to show you.